What's up, everybody? It's me, it's Alexis Maurice and
Trey Hollywood.
And it is time for a new episode of the Wine Up. Wine it up, wine it up. So go ahead and pour yourself a glass of wine. As you can see, we've already been drinking. This stuff is good. We're drinking on some Sutter Home White Merlot. Ladies, put on some lipstick. Fellas, if you use lip balm, chapstick, whatever you use, pull up a chair because we are about to discuss the latest hot topics. Okay, now while we go ahead and take another sip, go ahead and like this video on YouTube. Make sure that you comment, let us know if you agree, disagree, or what your viewpoints are. Also, make sure that you
subscribe. Bash me.
Go ahead and make sure. Why nobody be bashing you?
It's a new thing.
Or whatever. Make sure that you subscribe to this channel.
Just spell my name right, that's all I ask.
In addition, make sure that you share this video on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, all of that good stuff, okay? Monique girl.
Now, if y'all know who Monique is,
tell them who they is.
Monique is the bad, mad, upset person from Precious. She's also the giggly, funny go-getter from the Parkers.
Mm-hmm. The mama.
Yes.
She's what's the girl name of the Parkers?
Constance mom. Kim. Yeah. Kim.
Kim. Is her name Kim on the show?
Yeah, her name is Kim on the show.
Oh, okay.
And Monique was mama!
Mama! Or whatever. So, Monique was actually doing a show at the Apollo. And here's what she had to say.
So no, I was not blackballed. I was whiteballed. By some black dicks who had no balls. Thank you, Mr. Lee Daniels. Thank you, Ms. Oprah Winfrey. No, baby, I wasn't blackballed. I was fucked up by some niggas who had no balls. And see, I know they like to say, Monique, you talk too motherfucking much. It would kill me not to say the real shit. It would kill me not to say the real shit. You are not paying me equally. You are not treating me fairly. So y'all can suck my dick if I had one.
When I first saw this video, I was like, oh, hell no. No, she did not just speak against mother. You were not Monique.
And
I refuse. You will not disrespect Oprah Winfrey like that. Oh, I don't know what the hell.
I thought mother was Lee.
No, I don't know what the hell got into you, girl. But one thing I will not tolerate and I will not stand for is you disrespecting Oprah Winfrey.
Yes.
You're not going to do it. Yes. Now, what had happened was Monique has been said ever since Precious, it's been put out there that she's difficult to work with. Or whatever, as a result of when they were doing the press run for Precious back in 2008, 2009, whenever that movie was released, it's been said that Monique wanted to be paid for the press run or whatever. So not only did she do this movie, but she felt that, okay, if I'm going to be going here, if I'm going to be going there, I should be compensated for this. And some of the people was like, no, there's no compensation for you doing a press run. Not only there's no compensation for you doing a press run, but girl, you got a Emmy nomination out of this. And not only did she get an Emmy nomination out of this, but she got an Emmy award. She won. Or whatever, the Oscar, excuse me. She got the Oscar award. And she won for her portrayal of Precious' mother. Right, exactly. How do you feel about this situation?
You know, to be honest with you, I kind of think that, what do you call it, a movie run?
Press run.
A press run. I don't really honestly disagree with the fact that her maybe getting paid for a press run. But let's think about it. If you're doing a press run, you might be going from different states. Possibly.
Nine times out of ten.
LA, New York.
Right.
Maybe Texas.
Right.
You might end up
wherever needs to be going.
So you're taking away from time of you maybe doing other auditions. Let me speak. So you're taking away from her being able to do other auditions, other movie roles and stuff like that to promote it. Now, when you sign a contract onto a movie, you know that you're going to have to promote the movie.
Right.
So you have to think in your mind, okay, when this movie comes out, I got to go here, there. So I don't feel that Monique is in a place in her career where she can make those type of demands.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I see okay if it's maybe Sandra Bullock, Angela Bassett, maybe even Loretta Devine.
Mm-hmm.
You can maybe make those demands.
Mm-hmm.
But Monique, you don't really, for a movie like Precious, where it was only probably promoted by black people, you can't really make those demands. But I see where she's coming from.
So here's my thing. I see where she's coming from too. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, girl, you got nominated for an Oscar.
Yeah, that's big.
That's big.
But the body is, that's after the fact.
No, it was after the fact. But, you know, you got nominated for an Oscar. To me, that's enough. There was Oscar buzz before she actually got nominated anyway, or whatever. But a lot of it has to do with the press that comes along with being nominated for an Oscar too, because you have to attend this breakfast, you got to attend this brunch, you got to attend this luncheon, you got to attend this dinner.
Ooh, I can't wait.
And it's like a whole 6 weeks of campaigning,
right,
or whatever. So, but she was like, no, I don't want, I'm not doing this, or give me some type of compensation for this. My thing is, if you're passionate about the project and you really love and want to be a part of the project, I don't think, me personally, I don't think you should receive compensation for this. Now, I get where she's coming from, because there are a lot of stars, naming like Angela, Sandra Bullock, or, you know, those A-list actors and actresses who may receive that. I know Kevin Hart is making a big deal about it. One of his movies that he had last year where they wanted him to post on his Instagram, on his social medias, promoting the movie. But he was like, y'all gonna have to give me some money for this or whatever if I'm promoting this for you.
But don't you want people to come to your movie?
Exactly. Like,
to see your movie?
You do want people to come to your movie, so there should be no reason. It should be okay with you actually promoting this. Monique, my thing is, you're entitled to your opinion or whatever. Nobody can take that away from you. But I think, now I'm not in Hollywood yet, but I think you have to be careful coming out and saying these things against some of the movers and shakers in Hollywood, like Oprah Winfrey, specifically Lee Daniels and Tyler Perry or whatever. But at the same time, you have to sit back and take inventory of yourself.
It starts with self.
Now, Tyler Perry, Oprah Winfrey, and Lee Daniels are not the only only producers in Hollywood. There are other producers or whatever. And if they don't want to work with you either, is it really that they have, you know, Tyler Perry, you know, Lee Daniels and Oprah, have they really blackballed you? Or, you know, is your craft where it needs to be? You know, you have to look at that. And really, are you in a position where you can be making demands like that? But some people say she is, because of the fact that she earned and she won an Oscar for her performance or whatever.
See, this is the thing I want people to understand. I may get cussed out for this. But what I want people to understand is the way for a black person, because we live in a white man's world, the way for a black person to win an Oscar is to act ignorant or show your breast or have sex with a white man.
That's
or
your
woman.
Opinion.
Example.
That's your
opinion. Denzel Washington won an Oscar for Training Day.
Right.
My opinion, he should not have won.
Mm-hmm.
He was in a category against Will Smith,
mm-hmm,
who should have won for Ali.
Mm-hmm.
The only reason Will Smith won that award is because he acted like an ignorant ass.
You mean Denzel won the award?
Yes. Halle Berry, that same year, won an Oscar because she showed her tits and had sex with a white man in that movie. Now in time now, it's changed a little bit, and I believe because
Jennifer Hudson won the Oscar and she didn't show no tits.
That's because
she wasn't playing no ass person.
It was because it was a singing movie, and, you know, it was nobody else.
It was based on her talent.
It was nobody else in the category that really
was
like
based
heavy
on her talent.
They knew she was supposed to win. Just like she got a star on the Walk of Fame. I mean, she's a white woman. Jennifer Hudson is white. I'm going into the channel there. Since she lost that weight, she white. She was a sister when she was fat. Now she white.
You sound ignorant.
Okay? She is Sarah Jessica Parker now, okay? That's what she is. Nowadays, you have people like Viola, who's winning. Because she's playing strong.
Her talent.
I'm getting there.
Okay.
She's playing strong black roles.
Right.
A woman who is talented. A woman who is displaying stuff. So
Monique, that dispels your...
No, I'm talking about then, when she was making movies. Monique ain't really made no movie to do that.
Well, she said she ain't made no movie because Oprah and Tyler and Lee Daniels putting it out there that she's difficult to work with.
I'm backing off,
or they're
I'm
perpetuating.
Backing off what you were saying. Where you gotta put yourself out there, and it starts with self.
Right.
Make yourself strong, make yourself known, mm-hmm, in that type of role like Viola has did.
I don't think...
Like Taraji has did.
Right, Taraji. I don't think coming out and publicly saying these things... Mm-hmm. For one, I applaud you for standing up for what you believe in.
I don't.
But it's just the way that you go about doing it. There's already enough heat on black people when it comes to in Hollywood being seen equal. The last thing we need is for each other to be tearing each other down and stuff like that.
Right,
if you really felt that way, meet with Oprah, Tyler, and Lee together or individually and try to hash things out.
I'm sure you can get in contact with Lee because you don't work with him. I'm sure you can get in contact with Oprah because of who you are. But girl, you done messed up.
Yeah,
the white people already ain't working with you.
Yeah.
Because you did Precious.
The black people don't want to work with you. And so, if I mean, sometimes white people, they do go tap the black people's shoulder. Oprah, Tyler, Lee, what do you think about this Monique? And if they're saying that you're difficult to work with, it is. Now, Monique, I'm going to be honest with you. You do come across these last couple of years as a real bitter, angry black woman or whatever. And I'm sorry to say that, but that's what you give off. You just seem like you're always mad and angry about things. But if I was to put myself in her situation, if my peers are blackballing me, I probably would feel some type of way as well. But coming out and bashing them and saying that they can suck your dick and all kind of stuff like that, that's just a little bit too much. Now, Sheryl Underwood actually came to Monique's defense. And here's what Sheryl Underwood had to say.
Monique gave me one of my first jobs. I feel this is unfortunate because we love Lee Daniels and what he's doing. We love Tyler Perry. We love Oprah Winfrey. And if there's a way for us to settle this so she's an amazing actress and an amazing comic.
She is,
so somehow we gotta settle this together. You know what I'm saying? And the hard part about this is other people make demands and they still get to work. But, and I'm not saying I agree with what she did. I'm just saying I'm concerned about my friend right now.
I actually say I have to agree with Sheryl. Take this stuff off camera and try to work it out amongst yourselves and not work it out in front of everybody or whatever. Because to me, I just think you're further alienating yourself. But again, there's more producers out there besides Tyler Perry, besides, you know, Oprah Winfrey, besides Lee Daniels. Let your work speak for you. Use what your talent, use what you have to try to book other gigs outside of maybe necessarily working with them.
What?
Did you see this video of Matt Jordan and Peter Thomas? Okay. So over the weekend. You sent it to me. So over the weekend, Friday to be exact, if I'm not mistaken.
Because you called me without
right. What had happened was the video of Matt and Peter has finally surfaced. Now, if you guys remember, I think back in March, there was rumors of a brawl between Peter and Matt at Power 98 in Charlotte, North Carolina. And so take a look at this video and tell me what you think.
Everybody always gives Peter and Todd a platform, and you
I
don't
never
ever
told
get
you, that.
You did, and I you said that you don't get your platform.
I said
so that's
don't
what
get
I'm
the
getting.
Fellas a platform.
Okay, so I'm giving you a platform.
But I'm not gonna argue with this bitch ass nigga while I'm trying to talk about some irrelevant shit. You know what I'm saying?
So talk to me. Just chill out for a second and talk to me. Have a conversation with me.
Scary ass nigga. Why you pull up and come talk to me, nigga? I tried to meet you last night.
Matt,
what's up?
Matt.
We could have squared this away,
Matt,
bro.
I'm scheduled.
Matt.
Yeah, you are. You my bitch, bitch. Matt.
You see me?
You see my bitch, bitch.
All right. Conversation over.
What?
Conversation over.
I was on your way.
Matt, are you fucking serious? Are you serious?
Yo.
What do you think about this whole video? This whole situation? To me, Matt looks like he got his ass beat. And to me, it does.
I don't necessarily think Matt got his ass beat.
But he lost.
I think the way you approach the fight is it's all the start of how the fight goes. Damn. If you go in swinging, you might hit him, knock him out, blah, blah. But if you go in trying to grab, you may get flipped. And I feel that that's what Matt did. Matt got flipped. Now, what he forgot
he
was.
Spent six, hold on. 3, 6, 4, 6,
this is my point. This is my point. I think he forgot that Peter's Jamaican. Okay?
Underestimated?
You might have thought he was old. But motherfucker, he went back to his roots. And that's all that motherfucker did was fight.
He put his ass in a headlock, and he couldn't get out.
Matt had him at one point, but
Peter, it must have been towards the end.
It was towards the end.
He got out of the headlock.
I'm going to tell you what pissed me off the most about this, is that why in the fuck, hold on, I want to look directly at the camera when I say this. Why the fuck was the woman trying to break up this fight when that man was standing there?
It was two other men in that room.
At first. first, when it was just the man and the woman, and she was telling him to calm down, and he went over there and jumped on Peter, she's the one trying to break it up, and that man is standing there. I need to find you. I need you to know you are a sorry sack of shit.
Right.
To sit there and allow that woman to try to break in that fight, and you go and call another man and try to get another man to come
in. Well, first of all,
what the fuck was you doing?
When they started fighting, she should have got her ass out the way. She ain't had no business trying to break them up. You got to be careful when you try to break up people when you're fighting.
All she thought about was computers.
Whatever. All of that stuff can be replaced. Or whatever. She was thinking about all that stuff. That ain't your shit, girl. That's the radio stations. If something break down, they'll pay for it.
Her check.
Or whatever.
But she the one brought him up there for that interview.
But the thing about it is, you got to be careful when you're trying to step in and break people up. Or whatever. You can't do that. Or whatever. If they're gonna fight, step out of the way and let these men fight. Eventually they'll stop, they'll get tired. Peter ain't, you know, Peter up in age, so he ain't gonna go but so far. Or whatever. But Matt, you know, now I'm gonna be honest with you. To me, I think this was a setup. I don't even believe that altercation between them was really real like that. Or whatever, because look at the way Peter had Matt in the headlock. It looked like he wasn't holding Matt. But Matt was doing all of these theatrics and stuff. I was just like,
he didn't want to hurt the young man.
I don't think he really had him in the headlock like that, like that.
Like that, like that.
Like that, right there. Because Matt was just the way it was moved, he was moving. It just seems strange. They're saying that Matt was trying to pry a box cutter out of Peter's hand. Apparently he had a box cutter. He was about to slice and dice that bitch. Or whatever, but
he's trying to do some time.
You know, I don't know. So Matt is suing, allegedly, not only suing.
Who said that?
Honey, Matt said it. He said it. Or whatever. We going to the source. Matt is not only suing for his finger, saying his finger was damaged in the altercation, but he's also suing the parent company of the radio station. I don't know if it's Radio One or Klitsch. I don't know who it is. Urban one now.
Girl,
actually.
He ain't getting no check.
But no, he's suing them saying that he did not sign off on the release of that footage. And it should not have been released. And so therefore he's suing them.
Okay,
now.
But you started to fight.
Matt ain't get his check from Kenya. He gonna find a way to get his check somewhere.
He ain't gonna get this check either. Mm-hmm. You started the fight. You started the fight.
You drove all the way to Charlotte.
So fucking stupid. See, you know, I had your back before. But now I'm sick and tired of your shit. Because how you going to say you're trying to sue this radio station when you the one agreed to come up to this, do this interview, knowing Peter's going to be there, knowing you a bitch-ass nigga, knowing you got an attitude problem, it is the one who started the fight. Threw the bottle over at Peter while Peter was just sitting there.
I don't think they knew that Matt was coming, though. I think he just showed up at the radio station.
Even more reason why you're not going to win this lawsuit.
But my thing is, you're right. You can't start the fight and sue because of the fact that you threw the bottle at him first. So therefore, that's assault or whatever.
That's,
and then
like
you ran over and you approach him. You attack him. How you gonna win? How you gonna claim? Tell me some of your finger broke and all kind of stuff like
that's
that.
Like me going on jet, meeting up with some guy, sending him messages saying I wanna have sex. We meet up. I have on this lingerie. You know what I'm saying?
Are you wearing lingerie now?
I'm just saying. And then
wearing a teddy.
I might be wearing something, you know? So, and then we sitting there having this conversation, and I'm like, I don't want to have sex, but I done told you, you got proof.
Oh, bitch, you gonna give me this ass.
Hello?
You gonna give me this damn ass.
Right.
You ain't even gonna
sit here and come to this thing, not even announce it.
Open them legs. Or whatever.
I can't stand that. You know what? Don't ever. Ever. He trying to stay relevant in these streets.
Listen, Matt, I don't know what to say. All I can say is, you going to try to find somewhere to get your check. So, if that's what you feel you got to do,
find
get your
Jesus,
check.
Man.
But all I know is, from it looked like, to me, it looked like it was a little stage. But at the same time, Peter had that ass in the head. Or Matt couldn't do nothing. Your big 6'3", 6'4", 6'5", ass, 200-something pounds, and you let Papa Smurf put you in that smirk headlock, child, and you couldn't get out? Really?
I was like, come on, Peter.
I would have did a spin side kick, yes, Charlie, type
Zaddy.
Chikapaya or something,
yes,
like that.
Zaddy.
Or whatever. What are you doing?
I was saying, yes, Zaddy.
To what?
Peter. He handled his business. He held it down. No wonder Cynthia was so hooked.
Okay. Let's talk about the BET Awards. So the 2017 BET Awards, which is scheduled in June 25th, if I'm not
mistaken. It's always around my birthday.
Or whatever. The nominations came out. So let's go through some of these nominations. Best Female R&B and Pop Artist. Beyonce, Kalani, Mary J. Blige, Rihanna, or Solange? Who do you think is going to win that?
I think who should win it is Rihanna.
Mm-hmm. But who do you think will win it? Rihanna. I say Beyonce's going to win there. Best male R&B pop artist. You got Bruno Mars, Chris Brown, The Weeknd, Trey Songz, or Usher?
Bruno Mars.
I think he's going to win that as well, too. Yeah, yeah. Best group, 2 Chainz and Lil Wayne, A Tribe Called Quest, Fat Joe and Remy Ma, Migos and Ray Shmurda.
I'm between Migos and Fat Joe and Remy Ma.
I think Migos got this one. Mm-hmm. I think so. Mm-hmm. Best collaboration, Beyonce featuring Kendrick Lamar, Freedom, Chance the Rapper featuring 2 Chainz and Lil Wayne, No Problem, Chris Brown featuring Gucci and Usher, Party, DJ Khaled featuring Beyonce and Jay-Z, Shining, Migos featuring Lil Uzi Vert, Bad and Bougie, Ray Shmurda featuring Gucci Man, Black Beatles.
I'm between Chance the Rapper and Migos.
I'm between Chance the Rapper and DJ Khaled and Beyonce for Shining. Mm. No, you know what? You're right. Bad and Bougie might win now.
Yeah.
Bad and Bougie might win now. Yeah. So, let's talk about best hip-hop artists. Big Sean, Chance the Rapper, Drake, Future, J. Cole, or Kendrick Lamar?
Kendrick Lamar.
Chance is going to win that one.
Only because he won a Grammy, right?
Yeah. I think Chance is going to win that one. Best female hip hop artist, you got Cardi B. Congratulations to Cardi B. Or whatever.
That's
amazing.
That's dope, yeah.
Or whatever.
I love Cardi B.
Missy Elliott, Nicki Minaj, Remy Ma, or Young Ma.
First of all, I don't even know who the fuck Young Ma is.
Yes, you do. Do 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 do.
What is that?
Do 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 do. I call her Stephanie. Hey. Oh, that's da, 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 da. Yeah, that's Young Ma. Her new song is hot.
She's gonna win. So I'm gonna go between Remy Ma
and Nicki Minaj. Yeah. Video of the year: Beyonce, Sorry, Big Sean, Bounce Back, Bruno Mars, 24K Magic, Migos, Bad and Bougie, and Solange, Cranes in the Sky. This is the second category. Beyonce and her sister are up.
I'm gonna say Solange. Yeah, I'm going to say Solange. Have you seen the video?
No.
I'm going to say Solange.
I have a feeling Bruno's going to win that one.
I would love him to win it.
All right. Video Director of the Year. We're going to skip over. We know. Video Director of the Year, Benny Boone for Kalani Crazy. Bruno Mars and Jonathan Leah. That's What I Like. Director X, Zayn Malik for Like I Would. Hype Williams, Tigger, Gucci Snakes featuring Designer, and Kalia Joseph and Beyonce Knows Carter, Beyonce
That's
Sorry.
That's actually a good category because all of those videos are actually good. And all those videos
I don't even watch videos anymore.
All those videos are actually directed by some good people. But I'm going to say, I'm going to say Benny Boom, Kalani.
Okay. Best New Artist, 21 Savage, Cardi B for her second category, Chance the Rapper, Khalid. And Young Ma.
I'm going to say... Let's go with Cardi B.
I don't think Chance the Rapper's going to win that one.
I don't think I'll give it to him. I think he won a Grammy.
Yeah, Chance the Rapper, Best New Artist. I think he's going to win that one. And either Chance the Rapper or Young Ma. I think it's going to... Young M.A. I think that's how you say her name. And Album of the Year, 24K Magic, Bruno Mars, 4 Yards Only, J. Cole, A Seat at the Table, Solange, Coloring Book, Chance the Rapper, and Lemonade, Beyonce.
So who do you think is going to win that?
I think Chance the Rapper is going to win that again.
If Bruno Mars does not win that category, I'm going to be highly upset.
So you think his album is the best out of those five?
That is the best album released in 2016.
Okay.
That album is amazing.
Okay.
That's how I like it. That's how all my love is. That motherfucking album is amazing.
We want to thank you guys so much for watching this episode of The Wind Up. Again, make sure that you like this video, subscribe to our channel, and make sure that you share it on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat.
One more time. It's free to share the fucking video, so share the fucking video.
Why you gotta cuss at people?
Sometimes you gotta be direct.
No, you don't. But when Steve Harvey was directing, you found a problem with that.
That was just
come on. No.
It was rude.
Oh, you don't think what you just did was disrespectful?
No, I'm just telling them to share the fucking video. I don't mean
why do you have to cuss at the people?
Okay, look, my African Caucasian brothers and sisters, queens and kings, would you please share the video?
Thank you. That sounds a lot better.
To share the video.
But like I said, you had a problem with how Steve, and he didn't even use cuss words. You have a problem how he addressed his staff, but you address our following people who don't get paid to follow us?
I don't give a damn what Steve Harvey did.
You see that? He but you did for the other episode and a half ago.
He was ignorant for that damn.
And you're ignorant for addressing our followers the way that you did.
I sincerely do apologize for cursing at you all. It was not in my intent to be harsh, disrespectful, or anything like that. It was just basically to let you know that it's fucking free to share the video.
And he does.
So share the video.
Thank y'all for watching, and we will see y'all next episode. Bye. You are so disrespectful.
I love him.